remember what has been the build-up, the marketing campaign for the past few months of Doctor Who, it feels like? It has been the hashtag Find the Doctor campaign, where through actual items that you can see in real life, like the portrait that was in a Liverpool art gallery, like in the videos that have been done where the Doctor has been messaging Yaz and Yaz has been messaging the Doctor, vice versa, or also the Doctor Who newsletters and stuff, where they've been highlighting single letters in certain words on the newsletter to try and point us to a code to crack the online Find the Doctor, Doctor Who mystery thing. Well, it was meant to end in a couple of weeks' time. However, as was pointed out by Twitter user at Matt Umby. By the way, if you wanted to look at Matt Umby's account, it is not safe for work, so I've just got the tweet here, not the actual full account. No disrespect to Matt Umby, but you know, it's a live stream. So Discord just solved hashtag find the doctor by finding the password in the site's source code, DC5EGYVANVETE, leads to an exclusive pic of Jodie and this video. We'll talk about this first. So we had basically all but three of these letters, or at least all but two of these letters confirmed. However, what happened was that Discord or Reddit went into the site's source code and found the password, basically putting an abrupt end to hashtag find the doctor. And as soon as the password was broken, they went back into the source code and found that the password had been changed. And the link we got led us to this video.
Yaz, sorry, I got sidetracked. Bear with me. Just trying to outmaneuver a Baldarian warfleet and make a sandwich at the same time. Not ideal. Be with you in 5 minutes. Make that 6 minutes. Then I think we should hit the beach planet with the 17 suns. Just need to dig out my Factor 7000 sun cream. Oh, also, if you pass a shop, can you get some milk? See you soon. Kisses.
So yeah, I guess the standard message that we've seen this type of stuff before for hashtag find the doctor. However, this video contains a few images which we're going to talk about in a moment. But firstly, we got this promotional image. This one of Jodie Whittaker, high-res photo here in a full outfit on a soundstage with atmospheric bisexual lighting, I can only assume. And there's this congratulations message. Congratulations, you have solved the mystery and found the doctor. Below, you can hear the doctor's response to Yaz and download an exclusive image, all of that stuff. So yeah, we also got, at the end of the video, this. So yeah, two very, like, basically blink and you'll miss it clips, little video clips of this unidentified creature. Now, a lot of people have been saying this could be a Sontaran, and I think that actually might be a good shout. I think the Sontarans are very well known in terms of their iconography for what they look like with just their helmets on. And as long as you maintain just the potato head shape, you can do basically anything else with the Sontaran designs. Because I think if you were to give them these sort of sunken in eyes and these fangs, these teeth, I think you could pull off a Sontaran design, because what made the Sontarans, like, it was how they, it was scripted in the actual, like, script from Robert Holmes for the Time Warrior back in the 1970s, that one of the big surprises of the Sontarans was that the first episode of the Time Warrior is that you've just got this creature walking around in a full suit of armor, and then at the end of the episode, when the Sontaran is away from human views, but the Doctor is just, like, eavesdropping, is just hiding in a bush nearby, takes the helmet off, and it's the perfect shape of his head. Like, it is like a Russian doll. It was such a cool, unique look. And I think as long as you maintain just that shape, you can redesign whatever the heck you want. You've got the Sontarans from the Invasion of Time as well. Let me just bring that up real quick. So yeah, not the most flattering picture, but you can say what you want about the story and everything, but that is fundamentally, recognisably a Sontaran, despite the aesthetic changes within the face. I think one aspect that you could really bring on is just a couple of, like, hairs on the eyebrows, the protruded, like, eyebrows and everything like that. But as long as this shape exists, as long as this shape is maintained, do whatever the heck you want with the Sontaran designs, as far as I'm concerned. And I think that it's a little bit disappointing that the whole Find the Doctor thing has come to an end like this. I also think that these images might have dropped at the same time as a trailer, but we don't know Obviously, there's no way of knowing that absolutely for sure. Somebody in the chat as well thought that it could be Tim Shaw. I don't think so. Because when you look at these images, there's like no teeth. I think the visual aspect of the stanza of Tim Shaw in particular that you need to maintain is the teeth in the face. I think there's absolutely no point in bringing back Tim Shaw if you're going to lose his main visual gimmick. Earthshock Audio says, I think you missed what I said earlier. If you check Richard Lloyd's Twitter, he figured out what the final clue actually was. Let's do it. I've had segments on this live stream where it's basically been Richard Lloyd Appreciation Minute. Follow at Stetson Doctor as well. Do that. Here we go. So, Mystery Soul, find the Doctor complete. ETE Shazam. What's the Shazam about? I imagine, is it like the app? Mystery complete. Here we go, officially solved. The final clue comes from using Shazam on the video message. Ah, very cool. Very cool. Yeah, so you use Shazam then. Okay. The reason that the code got cracked was because they put out a video where you reverse the audio and it's like, have you found the clues? Have you found this? Have you found that? And it was with that final clue that Discord or Reddit at least had enough of the pieces in order to actually go into the source code of the website, as is my understanding of it. Richard Lloyd's second Akinola videos are fantastic. Yeah, brilliant. It's got one of the best mic drop moments ever, where the music notes that underpins Grace from series 11 and series 12, the note that underscores her entire theme is literally called a Grace note, which blew my mind absolutely. But folks, what do you think, by the by, of this photo if Twitter decides to load it? What do you think of this promo image? Yay? Nay? It seems, you know, it's a cool image, but it does seem incredibly basic to have been the culmination of a months-long campaign. Like, before Series 10 was broadcast, we had that photo of Peter Capaldi as the 12th Doctor surrounded by the Mondasian Cybermen. Now, I understand that photo was only shown because the Mondasian Cybermen's involvement in Series 10 was about to leak, so they kind of wanted to get ahead of that. They wanted to get ahead of it. But, you know, it just shows the absolute comparison, like the pure minimalist style. It looks cool. I've seen people use it, like, I edit the photo. I've seen people have it as their, like, phone background. It looks cool, but it does seem, you know, very minimalist. But for Find the Doctor, like, you know, it's been a fun ride. I wish that they had done more marketing on top of Find the Doctor. I wish there had maybe been more than just the San Diego Comic-Con panel, that there'd been more than just the very short trailer that we got at the Comic-Con as well. But in terms of, like, because that was actually the start of it. We had the Comic-Con panel, and then people noticed the out-of-place letter at the end of the trailer, and then they found the mystery site, which began Find the Doctor. But now we've got, but apart from Find the Doctor stuff, we've had basically absolutely nothing else in terms of the marketing. I do think that we're going to get a trailer. I say do think, I'm not placing money on this, I'm not making a bet again. I do think that we're going to get a trailer after Vigil has finished broadcasting. I'm not saying that Vigil is going to end this Sunday and then there's going to be a trailer saying here's what's coming next on Sunday on BBC One for the next few weeks. I don't think it's going to be that instant, but I think that because the BBC have multiple shows to look after at a time, and they seem to be in a habit of just promoting the one drama or sometimes two dramas at a time based on like the day that they're broadcast on. Like, they're not really marketing much else on Sundays with the exception of Vigil. Once Vigil's over, it will be either the next HETV, high-end TV drama that will follow Vigil, or it will be Doctor Who. Elliot asks, when does Vigil finish? This coming Sunday. It's the last episode this Sunday. So it could be there. But then again, it made sense when Line of Duty ended earlier this year and they had a trailer for Vigil, because it came from a similar production team. It had similar crossover cast members, notably Martin Compston. So it made sense to promote Vigil way ahead of time for the finale for Line of Duty. Same demographic, same type of genre. There's definitely some genre overlap and crossover there. Whereas I don't think that Vigil and Doctor Who have much crossover audience. But Vigil has been doing really well. Vigil has been a really big success on BBC One on Sunday nights. It's drawn in about like 9 to 10 million viewers, 7-day figures. So it's been doing really, really well. Tom Mason says, you said duty wrong, Mr. I can say duty however I like. It is my live stream. I have that power.